Women tend to be promoted at lower rates than men, and this accounts for the majority of the overall gender pay gap. Among US corporations, women comprise 48% of entry-level employees, but only 38% of middle management, 22% of C-suite executives, and 5% of CEOs. Can differences in social interactions, or schmoozing at work, partially explain these trends? Workplaces are social environments, and interactions between employees and their managers may influence career trajectories. But anecdotal evidence suggests that women often feel excluded from the kinds of socializing that can give their male counterparts a leg up in promotions. This paper provides novel, quantitative evidence that social interactions affect employees' careers and they contribute to the gender pay gap. The data derive from a large commercial bank in Southeast Asia with millions of customers and thousands of employees. This firm is typical in that female representation falls sharply at higher levels, and its gender gaps in pay and promotion rates are similar to those in other firms in both developed and developing countries. To start, the authors examine whether socializing with a manager gives employees a boost in promotions. They exploit variation in social interactions driven by smoking habits and a crucial institutional fact. Managers in this firm rotate across teams as part of the requirement for managerial promotion. Transitions often occur on short notice, and testimonies suggest the assignments are as good as random. So, consider the set of teams who are assigned to non-smoking managers. Some will transition to a smoking manager, while others will transition to a new non-smoking manager. Comparing outcomes between the two groups before and after the transitions captures the impact on employees of receiving a smoking manager relative to the impact of receiving a new non-smoking manager. This figure shows the results separately for smoking and non-smoking employees. Prior to the transitions, both types have similar career trajectories. This is consistent with the idea that manager assignments are as good as random. But after the transitions, there is a clear divergence. Smoking employees are promoted more quickly when they are assigned to a smoking manager. 10 quarters after the transition, their pay grade is 0.7 points higher relative to smokers who received a new non-smoking manager. In contrast, non-smoking employees have similar promotion rates whether they are assigned to a smoking or non-smoking manager. This figure directly measures the smoker-to-smoker advantage by subtracting these coefficients from these coefficients. At 10 quarters after the transition, the smoker-to-smoker advantage amounts to a 15% effect on base salary. So, why are smoking employees promoted more quickly under a smoking manager? There is no evidence that they become any more productive, nor is it the case that managers favor employees who are more similar to them. There is no boost in promotions for employees who are born in the same province, went to the same college, or who are close in age to their manager. But the evidence does suggest that employees and managers who smoke socialize more, primarily through shared smoking breaks. After the transition to a smoking manager, smoking employees share substantially more break time with their manager, while there is no effect for non-smoking employees. The smoker-to-smoker advantage is also stronger when employees work in close proximity to their managers. This is consistent with the boost in promotions being driven by increased socialization and face-to-face interactions. To determine whether similar dynamics contribute to the gender pay gap, the authors apply the same analytical framework, but rather than measuring the smoker-to-smoker advantage, they estimate the male-to-male advantage. They find that while the pay grades of female employees evolve similarly, regardless of whether they transition to a female or a male manager, the pay grades of male employees rise more quickly with a male manager. Interestingly, there is also a complementary effect. Losing a male manager has little effect on female employees, but has a negative effect on the pay grades of male employees. As before, these dynamics appear to be driven by social interactions. Transitioning to a male manager increases the percentage of breaks male employees share with their managers, and the male-to-male advantage is concentrated in cases where employees and managers work in close proximity. Overall, 10 quarters after the transition, the male-to-male advantage is 0.54 pay grades, or around a 14% increase in salary. A back-of-the-envelope calculation suggests that removing this effect would reduce the firm's gender pay gap by 40%. Thus, this paper argues that social interactions can affect employees' careers and contribute to the gender gap in promotions. This implies that a range of corporate policies might effectively reduce the gender gap, including standardizing the review process to use objective indicators, and leveling the opportunities for socializing at work. More broadly, these findings highlight the importance of studying how face-to-face interactions shape career advancement, particularly in an era of working from home. To read more on this topic, you can check out the paper's references to other related work. This includes research on social interactions at work, and many papers studying the gender wage gap.